Welcome to Vinyl Friday. We have the star of the show, Starla. She is going to be creating a fabulous project. And over here, we have Jessica is on
Facebook.
Jessica's on Facebook. We're broadcasting both YouTube and Facebook today. So Jessica's going to be answering your any comments on Facebook, and I'm going to be manning YouTube. So start your comments coming. If you have questions about anything that Starla's doing, about any techniques that are being used, then ask them. We want to have a really fun, interactive, live conversation with you guys. And to get your mind started to be thinking, we're trying to come up with a new name for the creative team. Instead of being called the creative team, so far we have social education team, which is one of the ones that our boss wants, because we are on social media, we educate everyone. The other idea was Carl's Angels. I don't know about that one either. So help us think of a new name for the creative team, and maybe you'll win a fabulous prize if we choose your name. Okay, Starla, show us what we are making today.
We are making a super fun, different project. It's one of my new favorite things to do with deco foil, and really you can't do it wrong. So we've got our board. We're going to be using Mod Podge, paint, and a variety of colors. And the best thing about this project is you can't really do it wrong. So we're going to go ahead and get started.
We've got a couple names now: Creative Crew, Design Expressionists.
Ooh.
There's some good ones.
I like that one.
Oh. And
I'm behind the camera. Hi.
Okay. So since it's Halloween, well, not really Halloween, close enough, everybody's getting their fall stuff ready, and you gotta get your Halloween stuff ready, right? You wanna have it up for more than just a couple weeks. So we're just gonna prep our board. You don't need to do this really heavy because you're going to be covering all of this.
Creative Squad or Vinyl Design Crew.
Creative Squad.
Are some other ideas. Woo woo! Vinologists.
Oh, I like that.
The Vinologists.
This is so fun. We need something punny.
Punny?
Punny?
We like puns.
Starla is really good at punnies.
I think they're fun. Should have said pun, but that's just too obvious.
Oh, Tammy's asking how many are in the crew. There's, the Vixens. there's all of us. And Amy's missing. Amy's on the crew too. Yes, Elizabeth, we're naming who's the name of our, it's been the creative team, so we're trying to figure out a different name for that. Decorating Divas.
Ooh.
The Dream Team.
We are the Dream Team.
Yeah.
The Dream Team. I like the Divas one. If anybody wants to know where you get this cute board, I've done so many designs on this board. It's from Walmart for $2.77. Despite what their tags say, it's $2.77.
Five divas and some vinyl.
Two guys and a... What's that show? Two guys and a pizza place?
And a pizza, yeah.
Is it two guys and a pizza place? This is what we talk about.
They want to see the board. She's painting it right now. Getting it ready.
I'm trying to disperse the paint as best I can. I should have sanded this section right here. It's a little rough, but that's okay. Said it doesn't need much paint.
Starla, just go over again really quick what you're making, what you're using.
We are doing a different method of using the deco foil, which you would usually use for heat pressing with our Easy Read adhesive, and we're going to be doing, I don't know what you'd call this. It's kind of like a crackle art. I like to use it on my wood projects to add a little bit of a metallic streak through it, because sometimes the metallic paints, they're not really metallic once they're dry.
So, this is taking longer than I thought it would.
I said, don't worry about it, like, not being, I don't know if you can see the streaks. It's kind of everywhere. That's okay. Am I too high?
No, louder.
Louder!
Yes, please.
I'm yelling.
No.
I don't usually talk to myself, people, when I'm crafting.
Yeah, if you've got questions for us, we've got two people manning YouTube and Facebook, so keep the questions going. There's Bonnie on YouTube.
I want to know what all the viewers do when they're crafting. Do you listen to TV? Do you listen to radio?
Yeah, good question. Do you listen to TV, radio? What do you do when you're crafting?
Who listens to Disney movies? It's the only way I can finish my projects.
Starla, do you have a finished one to show? They want to see what you're...
Rick's on. Go Red Sox.
That's coming. I'm gonna show you this method, so stay tuned. I do have one finished. And we're going to put something fun Halloween on it, so maybe you guys can guess.
Listening to music. Lots of people listening to music.
Yes.
Yeah.
Something to keep yourself busy.
Or playing the TV in the background. Podcasts. There's some podcasts out there.
I like to sing to the Disney music, and I'm sure my husband thinks I'm weird. That's okay.
Lots of people listen to music.
Okay. So, we've got it. Well, okay, there's a couple places I missed, but
Starlets.
Okay, tell about the paint that you're using and the Mod Podge, too.
Tell about it?
Just what kind you're using.
Oh, I'm just using Anita's all-purpose acrylic paint. Can you see it?
So just an acrylic paint.
Yeah. Doesn't have to be anything fancy because you're just covering your board. And then just regular Mod Podge. I don't think it matters what kind. This is the Puzzle Saver. I've used the regular before. This is just what we kind of had on hand. So.
Okay, Starla, Teresa Jennings is wanting to know. She wants to do printable heat transfer vinyl on a dark colored apron. She's having a hard time finding printable HTV. Do you have any suggestions?
Silhouette sells one that's a printable inkjet vinyl for heat transfer for dark fabrics. It's not a vinyl, it's more of a paper. So beware, it might crack. But I do think that the dark fabric material is better than the light fabric material. The only downfall is that you don't print it in reverse. You actually have to cut it out and then stick it on. But if you have a really good printer, it's awesome. But just be warned, it might crack. Okay, so this is still a little bit wet, so I'm gonna wait just a minute. So what we're gonna do, Decofoil, well, what's the actual brand, I can't remember, iCraft, they have an actual adhesive or glue that you can put on this, but if you don't have it, Mod Podge will work. When I first tried it out, I didn't have this stuff, and I just tried Mod Podge or tried different methods, and I like the Mod Podge the best. So what we're gonna do, I think it's good. My hands are all black, but that's okay. So, I am just going to take, you can get just a brush like this, cheap, I don't even know what you call these. Something with a lot of bristles. The foam brushes are fine, but you don't get very good strokes. So I really like these ones with the Mod Podge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a little bit of Mod Podge down. Ooh, it's all goopy. And we've got several different colors that I've already used. Do you want me to put my hair?
Yeah.
So this will give you an idea of what's on the one I already did. But maybe if you want to see another color we put on there, we've got our purple, we've got our, I can't remember, magenta, purple, pewter, and our, I think that's called lime. Yep, lime. So Halloween colors. You can just take a regular one and crinkle it to get a distressed look. These ones, I just put the full sheets down on it and give a little bit more of a chunky look than I want. So save your already used pieces, because any foil left behind, it's still usable if you want to distress it, especially for something like this. And I pull it every which way. I don't know if you can see that drawing. Can you see the cracks?
Mm-hmm.
Scratch it. Just make it a little bit messed up. So, since it's Halloween, I'm actually going to take this one that I've already used, because it's pretty splotchy. So you're going to take your Mod Podge. Don't do a whole lot. If you get a whole lot, just kind of dab it out, because you just want to kind of do it sporadic. Not very much. So it's kind of like crackling. I guess I could compare it to that. But crackle, you get cracks, and this, you get a different look. So I'm going to take this piece, stick it over top, and then take the other color. And these can overlap right there. It's fine. Got a little bit of green on there from yesterday. So just doing a Mod Podge won't really set it. So it's the same concept as doing it with the Easy Weed adhesive for shirts or whatever material. Just take your iron. Right now I've got it on, I'm going to turn it down a little bit, rayon on wool, which is going to vary. And just go over it. You can kind of see it start to ripple. That's normal. It's just sticking to the glue. So there's two different ways to do it. You can't really do this wrong, I promise. So you can either wait for it to cool, which is what you do on the shirts. We'll see if it's going to go right now. It's a little bit. But see, where I don't let it cool, it's not really attaching to the Mod Podge. And it's not going to fully, just because the Mod Podge is kind of everywhere, and so is the specs. I don't know if I'm talking too much. Does anybody have any questions?
Amanda Trader says, I already have them all saved in my cart.
Yes! There's so many fun colors.
Elizabeth, I love those kinds of projects, the kind that you can't go wrong on.
You really can't, and that's why I really like this stuff. And you do the same thing on shirts. So if you like the distressed look on shirts, just keep your stuff. Oh, okay, ready? I'm not going to let this cool. I'm going to rip it. Look at all that still usable stuff. Don't throw your deco foil away until it's completely gone. There is a line. We're going to fix it. So, the best part is, what color do you guys want to see? Do you want purple, green? This is going to be whatever. Do you want the stars?
Tracy says green.
Green? Like this green? We're going to do this green. So, I'm going to do, that was a little bit much.
Lime.
Lime. Yep. We got lime.
Margin asks, where does the foil come from? So I'll put up a link, but do you want to talk about the foil again?
It is from, is it iCraft?
It's available on our website.
Deco foil. It comes from Expressions Vinyl. That's where you get it. So, yeah, and they have, I don't know how many colors there are here.
Okay. Show what she's doing again. Elizabeth needs to see this method again.
Okay, so I just took a scrap of the deco foil, and since I just kind of want to sporadically lay the green around where I put Mod Podge, I'm just going to be sure not to get your iron on the glue. You'll get glue on your iron. So that little iron, I should use the little iron. Just keep laying your deco foil around. That's why I said you can't really do it wrong. And if you don't like this line, which I don't really care for this line right here, I'm just going to kind of brush across.
Do you want a bigger piece? We have more green. What? You want a bigger piece?
Probably.
Amanda says, let's try teal.
Teal. Teal. Do we have a teal open? I have an order for teal. Cool.
Do you want a flash?
Ooh, I love
yes,
this.
Elizabeth, we did add more glue. So every time she does a new yes. color, she adds glue.
Here's a random hand.
And if you...
vinyl.
So this is... Okay, so where I put the glue right there, where it's a chunk like that, if I put this whole piece, it's just going to be a chunk. So maybe let some of it dry, kind of mess it up a little bit. Let's see what it does where it's warm from the iron. Not very much. So let's try the iron. So you see all those ripples? Can you see those, Joel? Mm-hmm. Where it rippled, there's her teal. So you don't have to load your brush every time, just kind of.
Joanne wants to know if the opal color would show up.
Ooh, let's try it. I did not think about that. That's a great question, Joanne. I had it.
It's right there.
So yeah, if you don't like, maybe one side has too much pink, purple, just keep adding. I mean, because there's no telling what it's going to do.
That's an opal.
Okay, opal.
Amanda's asking if you can use this with a heat press.
I'm sure you could. I just like to use the iron because you can just kind of hit stuff. I feel like you have more control with an iron, but try it out. This is very experimental. Okay, so I'm almost running out of Mod Podge. So where it's a little bit light on the Mod Podge, this time I am just going to throw the whole piece down.
Sandra is asking if we have orange.
They did, and they discontinued it, but we have
down.
Copper. Oh, that was the pumpkin.
Yeah, down.
We don't have it anymore.
Down.
Copper. We have copper, so we don't have orange anymore, unfortunately, which would have been perfect for Halloween, right? And I was going to do it for my project. So, who was it that asked about the opal? It's Joanne. Joanne asked about the opal. It works. Oh, look, there's a good shot of it right there. If it lifts up like that, take some multi-use paper. It's the same stuff you'd use to layer vinyl, heat transfer. Just set it. Oh, I'm everywhere. Okay, so we have got. What colors did we use? We used magenta, opal, teal,
and teal lime.
And lime. So that's pretty cool, I think. So you can either sand it with a sanding stone to kind of smoothen it out, because you will have some chunks, because every time you hit decalfoil, it kind of makes it cracked. Look, and that's why I like this. It's super fun to do. We should try the stars. Should we try the stars, people? Because it's Starla doing it. We have to add stars.
We have to add stars.
Jeez, so I'm going to do a little more Mod Podge here. Just a little bit. You've never tried this stuff for shirts. It's the same stuff. You can't mess it up.
Hey, and Basin's on again. Picking the kids up from school.
Okay, I'm just going to do a little bit because I don't really want stars everywhere. I really like these colors together, guys. And I really like the opal. That turned out better than I thought it would. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to lay the whole thing down because they're teeny tiny, tiny, tiny stars.
Janine is asking where we are located.
Shelley, Idaho! Woo! Idaho. Whoa, that's cool. You guys like my reaction? Do you guys see the stars? So I already Mod Podged over here, but I didn't do very much, so it's probably dried a little bit.
Maria wants to know if you're going to put vinyl lettering on top.
Of course. Oh, speaking of, we're going to be doing the 651, which is on sale right now. I don't know for what. I should have looked that up before I came up here. But the 651 is on sale. So you can let this cool. The longer you let it cool, I feel like it leaves more of an impression of the design behind. So it's up to you. I'm going to let this one cool a little bit.
Crystal's asking what the Mod Podge is for.
It's just the adhesive component, I guess you'd call it. It's just the foil is sticking to the Mod Podge because it's a glue, and then the heat is activating it. It's almost like it's curing it and shocking it. If you do it without the Mod Podge, it doesn't really work, or without the iron, it doesn't work very well. Okay. Ooh, that was a little bit much right there, but that's okay. So, say maybe I don't like how many stars are right there. I'm just going to Mod Podge a little bit. I feel like we need some more of that teal someone suggested. Just right there. I lost a roll. Okay. Anybody have any guesses as to what I'm gonna put on the one? Any Halloween maybe hints out there? What's gonna be going on the other one? All right. Should we try any other colors or should we go to the finished product? I feel like we need something right there, guys. Just add a little bit. Just right there. What should we
do? Something Halloween related.
I win.
What? We need hints here. We need hints. No one's gonna know. It's my favorite Halloween movie. No one's gonna know that.
Everybody say hi to Jen. She's watching.
Hi, Jen.
Jen from the office.
Hi, Jen from the office. I didn't know you were famous.
Says Jason. Jason was on earlier.
Jen from our office.
All the Evie employees that are supposed to be working. I'm just kidding. Okay, so that's what we've got. I mean, you really can't do it wrong, and it, I don't know how long this has taken us, but not very long. So if you want to add a cool effect to your projects, get some deco foil, put it on there. You can't do it wrong. I will sometimes go, like I said, and distress it if I want to kind of rough up any spots that are maybe a little more solid than I like. And sometimes if you've got the colors underneath, it kind of exposes some of the colors underneath. And then once it's how you want it, I just go put a sealer on it and let it dry. You can put a vinyl on it. So that turned out cute, guys. You guys did awesome. That'll be cute in a little girl's room. So
Christina is just tuning in and wants kind of a recap of what you're doing.
Oh, okay. So what we did, we painted a board, show it from the back, and we just sporadically brushed with a bristle brush, Mod Podge, just wherever you want, and then you take your sheets of deco foil, they can either be solid or you can crinkle them up, which I was going to show the crinkle, we'll go back a little bit, and then she can see it too. So you take a little bit of the Mod Podge, not much. And I was gonna add in this gold that I crinkled. I mean, this is a lot of colors. What might be kind of neat is maybe if you were to go with from the sides and try one color and just kind of go in, that might be a cool effect too.
Okay, Elizabeth is giving an idea of making a stencil and then doing the deco foil on top of the stencil.
I've thought about that. I don't know, with like the Aura Mask. Aura Mask is an awesome stencil vinyl. I just don't know how, if you stenciled it on and then just Mod Podge very carefully around your stenciled on spot into the deco foil, I think it would work. I just wouldn't put the heat transfer, the iron onto the deco, onto the Aura Mask. It might do something, maybe not. So we added just a little bit of gold in there. Just a little bit.
What type of sealer do you use with the wood?
My favorite sealer for like any craft project, you can get at Home Depot, and it's chalk paint sealer. It's awesome. It has like one of the best finishes I've ever seen. It looks nice and crisp. It's a matte finish. I don't know if you can get in gloss. But what I did on someone, I just did a Hobby Lobby brand. I can't remember the actual brand, but it's from Hobby Lobby. Just a gloss spray sealer. You can get Americana brand. Any sealer will work. So, okay, that's what we've got. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna show you the finished one. I'm gonna move this out of the way because I'm done with that. Okay, so here's the one we did yesterday. I'm gonna have to take the vinyl off so you can't see what we're doing. So here's what we did yesterday. So this one I didn't crinkle as much, so there's a lot more coverage for the purples and the magenta. But this I did chunks around and then just kind of filled it in, so it's a little more splotchy. So, no one guessed the movie yet?
A few people said Hocus Pocus.
Oh no, that's a good one though. I forgot about Hocus Pocus.
Somebody else said Jason.
Jason?
Or Nightmare Before Christmas?
Oh yeah, yeah. Definitely Nightmare Before Christmas.
Lacey said Nightmare Before Christmas.
Is it Lacey Perry?
Lacey Pham.
Oh, wow. That is a very good guess. So, I figured, who doesn't like Halloween movies like that? So we're gonna has a cool effect. So I've already got it cut out, and I actually was not going to hold that whole thing off, but that's okay.
Could you do this on glass?
It's a good question. Try it out. Tell us. Like, come back. Share Sunday. And everybody shares their fun project ideas. So I'm going to line this up with the edges here. Try to get it straight as I can. And I forgot my application tool. Application tool stat, Bonnie. Oh, look at that. Look how good she is, guys. Okay.
What type of vinyl did you use?
This is our Oracal 651 Black. It's a permanent adhesive. You could use removable. This one has been sealed. I maybe could possibly get the Oracal on the non-sealed one. I would be afraid it might lift. It's still lifting a little bit, but it removes very nice. And then I will go through personally. I like to spray them afterwards too, just to kind of get down. So since this board's kind of ski-wampus, I left this piece hanging off. Just take your box knife and clean it up.
Did you say you did not seal that one?
This one is sealed. The other one is not. It still lifted a little bit because I really didn't do a huge coat. I only did one coat of sealant on it.
Glenda's asking, what kind of transfer tape?
Oh, that was our Ultra Clear 12 inches by 30 feet for $10.
Nice.
$10.
We have Samira here from Dubai.
Ooh. Wow. That is awesome. This is not a very sharp knife, guys. I would suggest putting a fresh blade in when you do this. Okay. Here's the application tool. Okay. Of course, we have to add the moon, guys. This is also 651. This is the gold and yellow. I'm going to have to turn this on.
You can turn it around.
It's hard for me to do them upside down. Since I didn't know how this was going to look going back, I probably would have put like a white backer behind this so it offsets it just a little bit better. But doing this, you never kind of know what it's going to look like. So, okay.
Elizabeth would like to know the difference between vinyl and stencil vinyl.
That's a good question. I don't know if I have the best answer. I like the Aura Mask because it's a film. It's thicker and it's water-based. So I think it's easier to use. You can use 631 or just Silhouette and Cricut both have stencil vinyls. I feel like, I've never tried the Cricut stuff, but the Silhouette stuff, it's the same type of material, but with Aura Mask, I feel like you get a better bang for your buck. So try the Aura Mask. Okay, I'm missing something. We gotta add in our actual phrase right now. Okay.
There's a couple questions Glenda and Lori wanna know what you sealed it with again.
Oh, just any spray sealer. I did a gloss sealer because I kinda wanted it to bring out the shine of the foils. I'm whispering, Bonnie.
What do you think? Oh, you have it there? Awesome. Yeah, let's show it.
My assistant. This is what we used. I used, which one's gloss? This one. I used the gloss, but you can use either or. Like I said, I just like the gloss because it brings out the colors. So, okay, and this one is not 651. This one is our polished metal, and I kind of liked its little, Halloween green that it kind of brought out. And it's really hard to see on this, so this is also one of those things I should have just done white just in case so you could see it better.
Lori says, you don't reuse the transfer tape?
Ah! But if I wanted to save this as I was doing several of these, I would just put it back on my master roll, just wrap it around. I don't save them though, sorry. I don't. Okay, so that's what we've got.
Amanda wants to know, wait, what is the green vinyl?
Oh, that was the polished green, apple green polished metal vinyl.
I'll get a link up there.
And it's not like the metallics. It's basically the color version of the metallics. But there's not a green in the 651 that was close to that. It was a little bit more of a Christmas green or a spring green. So I changed it up and used the polish instead. So, but like I say, going back, I would have maybe done an offset to both of these just so it would bring it out a little bit more. So that's what we've got. I don't know how to end this to you guys, so. I want to see what you guys do with deco foil. You really can't do it wrong. Same thing with shirts. Try it on canvas. Try it with the stencil stuff. Just all sorts of different techniques. So, yeah, think of names. We still need some names for our creative team. I want to see what you guys do with this. Sunday is Share Sunday, so try it out. Yeah, and order you some 651 vinyl. Have a great weekend, guys, and be safe. Bye!